extra meat on my way there.
All right, I'm recording. Just bring us in whenever you can. Episode 28.
Okay. Light. There you go. Thank you so much for joining us. This is Game Edge, and we are back in 7 Days to Die with Pam.
Hi there.
Episode 28 for Cage. Hi, baby Cage.
That's weird.
And Dread, are you still a toilet pirate?
Yeah, I'm hearing stuff.
Right, he's the toilet pirate. Arrgh!
Toilet pirate. Wiping his butt. One ply at a time. He's all good. He's okay. So, yeah. So, actually, we decided to do kind of go through a game and review, guys, for 2016. There's been a lot going on in games, too, and we want to do a little game review and see what's upcoming, too, and what games failed us, like No Man's Sky, which then rebounded back with this amazing update, which I played. It sucked. I'll be dead honest. So, I didn't enjoy it at all.
The update wasn't good? I thought it sounded pretty good.
Whatever. Place this, place that. I don't know. Anyway, it left this bad taste in my mouth. I dropped $69 in that game. And once you've done that, and the developers, the way they acted afterwards, for me, just, that's it, done. I'm finished. I can't even make a video on it. I'd rather take the licking that is $69. It was kind of cool, but it was not much more than that. Just placing a bunch of little blocks. No matter what, if you're looking at space, you should be heading towards a game that Cage plays played quite a bit. I played a little bit of it, of course, and that is, you know what that is?
Imperium?
Space. Yes.
Yes.
Imperium is the leader in that.
Yeah, Imperium. It's so funny too, because Imperium, still nobody knows about it. My videos on Imperium do mediocre. I mean, they're pretty good, but they're not as good as I'd like them to be. And if you go to search for Imperium, if you guys use Google Chrome and you do incognito window, you got to do incognito window. That's the only way to get a proper search result. So I do that to search for Imperium. I do it to search for all the games I play to see where I am in the search list. And I am like the whole front page. I've been the whole front page since that game came out. And I still only get like 2,000-3,000 views per video. It's like, I don't understand why that game isn't bigger. I don't get it. Space Engineers is huge in comparison. And I've played both. And Space Engineers is a great game. I'm not shitting on Space Engineers. But Imperium is at least as good. Just in different ways, I guess.
Oh, yeah, for sure. But Imperium is very tactical. I mean, the amount of work that Cage puts in, you have no clue, people. You have no clue.
Today, it took me 2 hours to make a video. And it wasn't even me putting in work. It was, I have, auto miners down. So I go, I have to go to each one of my auto miners and collect the resources and feed more power into them. And then I have to put stuff into my factory to make my capital vessel. I got my capital vessel yesterday, and today I got a small vessel. And then I took the small vessel and the capital vessel to Skillen, which is another planet. And the reason I went to Skillen is because that's where you get the blue shards. The blue shards are the items that you need to warp. They're like the warp drive fuel. Okay. So I went to Skillen and I made a little outpost base. And it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. Yeah. But it is very time consuming, though. Even with the auto miners, it's still time consuming.
Yeah, I can't do it. I made that play that I'm not good enough. A, mentally, I just don't have the drive to play the game.
It's hard to push yourself to play a game like that when nobody's watching it on your channel, too. Yeah, you know?
Exactly.
That's the hard part.
Yeah, and let's look at a game that maybe turned around, which is Kingdoms. It looks like a good game that just made a nice turnaround.
Okay, so Kingdoms is an interesting one because you made the first video on Kingdoms, and I asked you about it, and you said it sucks.
It sucks because it's not perfect.
Then you made a second video, and I was like, he said it sucks. Why does he make a second video? So then I asked you again, and you said it's so grindy. And then I was under the impression you were done with it, and now you're telling me you're making a third video?
I am, because tell you the truth, it's grinding a lot, but it has so much possibilities. I want to test it out and see a little more about it.
Have you heard from the devs?
I have not heard from devs, and I'll be dead honest, I did not reach out to them at all. I wanted to kind of run through this process mentally and see what this is about. I want to see what this game, what they have in, planned. I do want to call them, call them up. I'll call them up on my shoe phone. But no, I want to know what else they're up to. But again, I don't think they're as out there as, let's say, 7 Days to Die, as the Fun Pimps. They're kind of like the forest. They're invisible. They're there.
Are they doing updates, though?
That's it. 17.2 is a big update, and we don't know anything else that's going to go on. But that is a massive,
Hold on. One more. When did 17.2 come out?
It just came out.
Okay, when was the last update before that?
God, 8 months.
8 months, wow.
I think it's about 8 months.
Do you think that update was 8 months worth of stuff, or have you...
Everybody thought it was dead, the game. That's what everybody thought.
Yeah, that's what makes me nervous. That's what's making me nervous.
That's why it's kind of, we're doing a little ginger kind of walk around step, you know, checking them out, seeing what the game, what they're going to do. Let's see what they're, you know, they have possibilities, maybe generate some, you know, some people interested in the game and push it, because it has a good concept. But man, that's a lot of work for a small dev team.
There's nothing worse in my mind. Like, I'm always nervous about playing a game and kind of like, I only play games I like. I don't know if you guys noticed that, but I think you're pretty much the same way. Like, some people be like, well, you know, you never say anything bad about a game. Well, it's because it, basically, you want to know the games I don't like, go look at the survival games I don't play or have never played. And even some of them I probably would like. I just didn't, not enough time, but you know, like, basically, I play the games I like. I mean, if I like, yeah, I'm not playing, Subnautica at the moment, but I have played it quite a bit, so obviously I like that game. But maybe some other games. Actually, is there any survival games I haven't played? I haven't played Out of Reach. I haven't played H1Z1. I don't like the PvP stuff, I guess. I guess that's what I'm trying to say.
What about Miscreated? Have you played that?
No, because that's like an H1Z1 clone. At least that's what it looked like to me. Is that not the case, or? Because I've heard people talking about Miscreated, and I assume, like, when I first looked at it, I was like, wow, that's H1Z1 through and through.
It is. It really is.
Okay.
I watch videos of people playing that, and it's pretty much everybody sniping each other, you know, grabbing stuff. But again, if you play a different way, I guess you can have fun with it. But the building mechanism is, you know, it's there, right? It's okay. But they have a lot of updates, too, didn't they? Dread, they had a new zombie there, that super screamer.
That's Miscreated?
Yeah.
See, that sounds like it's got some good AI, like some good PvE, maybe.
Well, the screamer itself is absolutely insane. Yeah, there is. We can actually. I was actually always curious about that game, but I never gave it enough shot. I didn't. You know, just something irked me about it. I don't know what.
What irked me about it is it looked like H1Z1. Like, yeah, you know, and H1Z1 looked like DayZ, and I couldn't. I didn't like DayZ either.
I guess the way we look, you know.
Do they have a single player version of that, or is that online only?
Good question. I think it's online.
They probably let you set up your servers the way you want, I'm sure. I don't think they're... It would be impossible to make a PvE server.
With Miscreated, if you want a server, they only go through one particular provider. And I personally like to set my own stuff up so that I can control who has access. So it's different. It's disappointing.
That's kind of
strange. I want to play the game. I've got the game. I want to play it. I did like a $20 down... pre-early access thing, and I haven't had a chance to play it because you get on, you get killed, and you're like, this is just Rust with zombies.
Mm-hmm. That's right. See, that's why I've seen too.
That's pretty much what I thought. That's why I didn't bother.
They take a bus, and they come around, and they pretty much all jump out, and they come take you out, and you're like, come on! And they'll spawn camp your body. That's what they do.
Good times.
You brought up H1Z1. Have you checked out the Just Survive, which I believe is the PvE only version of that?
No, I didn't even know there was such a thing.
Really?
We'll take a look.
Is it good?
I
have an H1Z1.
I don't know, but I know I've seen it, and people are talking King of Hill? About it.
That's not King of the Hill?
The PvP version is.
Okay.
But the Just Survive, I believe, is the PvE version, which is kind of what we were looking for when it first came out.
Oh, really? Well, see that's
they cool. also pissed me off with the shenanigans they pulled with their deal, with their paid shit.
Oh yeah,
that stuff really pissed me off. I mean, it wouldn't keep me from playing it. If the PvE is good, then yeah, we should look into it for sure.
That's another one too. Yeah, that's definitely another one. What's the other one too? There, Out of Reach.
Yeah, Out of Reach. I'm not sure if that was the one I saw someone playing. Pam, what was the one you and I played together? We bought it, like one day we played, and then we never touched it again?
Out of Reach.
Was that Out of Reach, Pam? Are you there?
Yes. Yes, okay. Out of Reach.
Yeah, that game seems interesting. I just don't know what PvE it has.
Well, yeah. they have a new update coming out. I know that. That's a big update they're supposed to be coming out with that they're going to
evolve. Suck.
Some female pirates and stuff, and other kind of cannons they're adding. They're adding quite a bit of stuff, actually. If you think about it, this game is growing really quick. I think they're going to come out. I think they're going to finally do something.
It took me 5 shots with a hunting rifle to kill a deer. I don't know what the hell was going on there.
Whoa. You're thinking of a game, so that's what it is.
I'm thinking
Hero
about...
Deer.
Oh. A hero deer.
And now I lost my mini bike.
Oh, you went running
after him? This is a great day today, I'll tell you. I found the mini bike, and the deer's dead, so... We're getting there.
We're getting there. Yeah, that's actually one I want
to. So wait, I'm sorry, because I was trying to shoot the deer. Is there any PvE? You said there's PvP or PvE in in well, of Out course. Of Reach?
No, I don't think there's AIs, is there? No.
Well, I'm
no
pretty AIs. Sure there was animals, wasn't there, Pam? I thought there was animals.
There was animals, yes.
Yeah, but not real PvE. Not like when you cut your teeth on subsistence, it's kind of like baby's first PvE, you know?
Yeah, yeah. No, you're right. But it's interesting. We should actually look. That's actually one I kind of like for us to mess around with and see if we can do something with it. But we never know. You need the hunting book, Pam? You need the hunting knife? No? Going once?
Probably not.
Probably not. Okay.
What game are you doing a voiceover for?
Oh, jeez. Jaws.
Jaws of Extinction? Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
Is that is that gonna,
let's is be that, specific. That's not a voiceover as much as a very small NPC part, right?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Is that gonna have a good PvE in it, or is that gonna be a PvP game? Do you know anything about it?
I know. Well, so far it's in development. It's on Kickstarter. And it's now off Kickstarter now. Sorry, whatever happened to it, we're not gonna.
It's on Indiegogo. We found it today.
Oh, that's the one we were looking up. Yeah, they pulled it off Kickstarter, right?
Well, it's on Indiegogo.
Yeah, yeah.
But isn't it gone though?
No, it's there.
We found it on Indiegogo, but we couldn't find it on Kickstarter.
Okay, that's strange. Yeah,
it's on Indiegogo and it's on GoFundMe. Both have the same exact page, but they're getting money different ways.
Why would they talk
about a Kickstarter? But I haven't seen the Kickstarter. Indiegogo's only been up for 1 month and they have one backer, so they're hurting for support.
Well, why wouldn't they be on Kickstarter, though? Like, that's what I don't understand. There must be a reason, because Kickstarter's the biggest one, and it's not like it costs money, right? So, like, why wouldn't they want to go on Kickstarter?
Maybe they're waiting to do it? To do it right? Because once you jump on there, you only have a limited amount of time, right?
Well, they sent me a mail asking me if I wanted to do a voice thing like you.
And, oh, cool.
Yeah, they even mentioned you. And they were like, yeah, GameEdged is going to do it. I felt like telling them, like...
Do it.
I don't want to do a voiceover. When can I play the game? I want to know what's going on with the game.
Do it.
Yeah, I probably will. Fun. I'm gonna ask him though. I'll be like, can you tell me anything about what's going on with this game?
Yeah,
because I'm really curious. You know.
Yeah, it's very curious, and it's be fun to do. Just a couple lines. It'd be fun to be putting it in there and see what happens, and see what the game flourishes or not. We'll see what happens. I think it'd be kind of cool.
And to be fair with that game, if you look at what they want to do with their funding, none of it is the devs taking the money. They want to invest it all in the game. So they have their own jobs. They're going
to
do.
Don't get me wrong. I'm not thinking they're trying to take anybody's money. I'm just wondering, like, are they having trouble getting funding? Like, what are they? Why aren't they on Kickstarter? That's kind of what I want to know. I don't know how it works. I'm sure there's a very good reason. I'm just kind of curious.
You're talking to someone who put $100 toward the Dead Linger. Okay. I am worried everyone's going to steal my money after that. That was a horrible, horrible decision.
I'm not even worried about people stealing my money. I mean, if I lose, you know, $50 to a game, whatever. I'm just worried about. You know, when I make a video, I like to talk well about the games I'm playing, and I don't want to talk well about games I'm playing that I'm not sure are going to be, you know. That's why, like, I'm a little nervous about Kingdoms. I'd really like to... I think I've talked to the Kingdoms devs, actually. I'm pretty sure I have. I don't remember. It's been a while.
Depends on what they're doing. I mean, if you got contact with them, it's always good to go back. If you can look back at the email and contact them and see what the hell they're
I want to say it was in a stream or something. I don't know.
The thing is, they always say they're doing something, right?
Yeah. As long as they're telling me, hey, we're alive and we're still working on the game. That's all I need to hear.
Yeah. Well, they're alive. They're definitely alive because we see that 17 point, you know.
Well, yeah, but 8 months, you know, up until yesterday. Like, 8 months is a long time, man.
Like Stranded Deep, right? Stranded Deep, where did it go? Stranded Deep disappeared for a long period. They had to rebuild the ocean.
I wasn't playing Stranded Deep, though. You know, like, that's the thing. Like, if they would, like, just come out and say, we're still working on it. The update's taking longer than expected. You know, we're working on it. We're working hard on it. That's all I need.
I don't think some of them have communication. They have a lot of issues with communication.
Yeah, I mean, the Fun Pimps had problems with communication, too, for a long time. And some would say they still do. But, you know, you know, like, I kind of feel like... I feel like if these developers could get people to like volunteer as a PR person, I'm sure they could find people like that. They really should try it because, like, they're not really from that world, you know. And they shouldn't be. They should be playing the game or making the game. Like, I don't really care how they deal with the public. It really shouldn't be part of what they're concerned about, in my opinion. So, but I don't know. Maybe they can't find people like to volunteer for that. I don't know.
Well, it's tough to find the right people that can match you and be with you. It's hard, man. It's got to be really tough to build a game like that. I can't even put myself in there. When I watch Cole Games doing what he's doing and still getting away with, you know, daily and still talking in the forums and receiving files and fixing people's saves files and working on everything, getting things, I'm like, I'm already winded just thinking of what. And he's got a full-time job.
Cold Games has spoiled us all because, like, when I don't see that same stuff from other devs, I start getting nervous, and that's probably not fair.
Well, he's an anomaly.
Yeah.
He's an anomaly. He's just addicted to his game.
Well, his game's doing unbelievably. I don't know how many he's selling. I know he sold 20,000 copies. And I also know, like, if you look at the reviews on Steam, they're overwhelmingly positive.
Yeah. So
I'm starting to get a couple people saying they're done with it because there's not enough content there. And I can understand that. And my suggestion to anyone who feels that way is step away for 6 months and come back and check it out again. I guarantee you there's going to be a lot of stuff for you.
This game is going to grow, constantly. Well, he's giving nibbles away. You know, he's giving little bits of stuff, which is smart from a developer to do. Giving away, you know, a solar panel here and some stuff that you can start building. And what he's about to build, and I can't talk to you. Well, we'll talk off camera about that. Unfortunately, I won't do it on camera because, unfortunately, people, I never like to put pressure. None of us here like to put pressure on a developer to a certain point. And he did mention what he was going to do. And I'm like sitting there going, that's really good. That's very ambitious. But again, if he says it, usually he can do it.
He hasn't said anything that he was going to do that he hasn't come through on yet.
Exactly.
Although we would have been playing, he said we were going to be playing multiplayer by now. But that's he changed his mind. You know, there was obviously other things that he had
to do. Well, it's because he's changing that part I could talk about. It's changing the behavior of the hunters.
Oh, okay.
So the hunters will have a behavioral, in other words, they might not even kill you until you aggro them. There's different things he's looking at to building those. That's what he's going to start seeing as a change of pace of the game completely. I actually want to talk to you about that on Saturday, but we were so busy getting Rust and other things going.
We're not even in the same channel on Saturday. So
that was a little bit. Yeah, it's a hell of a change. I mean, again, he didn't have to come out and even mention that. And that's how he works. So he has a thought process that comes out and he does it and he works really hard at it. And then sometimes he takes a little lax and he sits down and he reads all your stuff. I mean, that's insane. I don't even know how you do that.
He commented on one of my videos the other day. I'm like, oh, yeah, I noticed that bug. I fixed it. I was like, oh, wow. I was like, I didn't even know you were still watching my videos. I figured he's just hard at work. I know there's a lot more people making videos. So, you know, it's different when you and I were the only ones doing it.
Yeah. Hey, he commented, I think I should get a helmet for you. I was like, asshole. Get in a few weeks.
How do you get one-shotted by the hunters like that? I've never ever been one-shotted like you.
I don't know, why don't you ask him for the
sake. I think it's special for your game.
I said well, they can't really hit us from up here anyways. I'm just gonna piss them off. So I shot him. I wasn't gonna kill him, and then poof, I went, what the hell is that? That's war.
I didn't watch that video yet, but someone told me, like, because I was like, I'm trying to think of different stuff to do because I'm starting to come up to the point where I've made everything in the game. And I'm like, I'm going to make a forward operating base within firing range of the hunters and just start shooting at them and see what happens. And everyone's like, oh, yeah, GameEdged did that. It didn't work out too well for him. I was like, oh, really?
Okay, and then be careful because there's actually the BCU that he built. This is what I figured. The BCU he built gives you a certain area you can build around him. So put your last tile you want to build that you're thinking of building, like your actual blocks, whatever, place it first really far away. And if you're going to do something like high up where you want like a balcony, put it all the way around to find out exactly where it cuts off. Because you're too close to the base, you'll actually see you can't build there.
I was just going to make a 2x2 tower, very simple.
Okay.
With some windows or something.
Yeah, that's exactly it. I tried to shoot them from up high and it did not, what video is, when is this coming out? Wednesday? Yes.
Wait, so did you do it again? Because someone else told me that you already did it. Like,
no, I went back out and actually, I went back out to fight them, and I shot from the top, and I couldn't hit them with the SVT, but I could hit them with 9mm.
Okay. That's a problem with the rifle. The rifle has a range on it, and it's not that far.
The 9mm? No problem.
Oh, is the 9mm outranging the rifle?
I shot with a 9mm last time, and I hit that son of a bitch exact same location he was at, the same friggin' tree. So 9mm is probably
the most horrible weapon. I think the rifle's aim is off a little bit too, because sometimes you aim to the side and it kind of hits him.
Yeah, I agree. I agree. It is bad. Oh, it's okay. We're doing good. So what other games here we have left here? What's let's talk about before we end it. The big game we're all excited about.
Conan. That's now on Steam.
It is on Steam.
What do you mean it's on Steam?
You can't buy it yet. Don't get excited. Yep.
What? 1 second. I gotta go.
Gotta go. See you later. That's it for episode 28. See you later.
Is that multiplayer? Please tell me it's multiplayer.
Oh, it sounds like it.
It sounds like it.
Yeah, they talk about it. From what I'm reading, they're gonna have dedicated servers available at the get go.
Is it gonna be their dedicated servers? Or are they gonna allow other people to do them?
They haven't said.
Yeah.
So you better believe though, if I can do it, there'll be a server for us to play on.
Yeah. Oh my god, that game! I swear, God, it just looks freaking good. And then they showed a little bit of that video, and I went, "Oh, it's getting a whole lot better, isn't it?" I mean, I don't really like
they Conan did anything, but they did a stream for an hour where they played it, and they were all about the PvP. But I read what they said, and they said it's going to be single player, and there will definitely be PvE co-op. So,
oh, nice. Okay, yeah, I like that.
Yeah,
I'm in for that. I'll take it
because I'm not playing PvP. Rust is one thing with my friends, but I don't know if I want to do PvP that much.
But you can have people defend your base while you're gone.
I don't care.
I like that idea.
Yeah, but it doesn't matter because the people you're playing with will play constantly and have everything they need and get in anyway. Trust me. They're not going to make it impossible for people to get into your base because then people will rage. They'll be like, I can't get into this guy's base. And then they'll nerf anything that, you know, believe me, people will be able to get into your base. Believe me, I played Rust for a lot of years.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's a lot of discussion already about offline raiding. Please allow offline base raiding.
Oh, no. Oh, really? Yeah?
I'm surprised that's even a question. I just figured it would be.
Did the devs answer anything back?
They're gonna allow.
No, yeah, they haven't answered back, but the community has been just...
You can't have PvP without it. It's a staple. It really is.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to occur, but there are base protection options that'll be put in the game. So whether that's turrets or just your thralls protect your base, I'm not sure how they're going to do it, but that's what they've said they're going to do so far.
All right. Yeah, well,
you know,
it's something.
When I played Rust Legacy, there was ways to protect your base with extra doors and walls and stuff, and people just farmed up, you know, 100 TNT and or whatever, and they're gonna get in. Trust me, they're gonna get in. We gotta find a PvE server is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah,
and even then, they're gonna have to worry about anti-griefing. If they don't allow us to make our own servers, it's gonna be a rough go of it in the beginning. I guarantee you that. I mean, nice. I remember playing Rust Legacy where people built walls outside my front door. And I didn't have any kind of explosives, and my game was over. I had to restart in Rust.
Really?
I had my shack because you built a you didn't have you could build a little shanty shack, right? That was a pre-deploy or a pre whatever you could build it prefab. I did that. Someone built a giant base around me.
Yep.
I had one C4.
Probably in like one day.
I blew up the door, and there was like six doors.
Yeah, they probably did it in like one day too.
Yeah.
You know, I don't like rag on Rust PvP because I'm a crotchety old man. I've had some really bad experiences.
Crotchety old man.
You know? I mean, I am a crotchety old man, but that's not why. That's not why.
That's priceless.
So
I put that in the greatest of cage for 2016.
I actually still might have the video. It was on a PvE server, and the guy locked me in, and I made a video, a 15-minute video of me ranting and rage quitting Rust.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I might have it still.
Yeah. Oh, that's you.
I'll see if I can find it next week.
Yeah,
put that shit up.
I have the same love hate relationship with Rust. I love it, but the problem is I don't want to lose out because I can't log in for 15 hours a day.
That's what I'm saying, and that's the way Rust is. If you don't if you're not logged in like almost constantly, you're gonna lose your stuff. There's just no two ways about it. That's the way it is, and it didn't always used to be like that. Before sleepers, before it was super popular, you could go off for a day and come back and still have your stuff. And even if someone did raid your base, you at least had what was on your character, you know?
Yeah.
And then everyone's like, oh, but people are combat logging. And now I'm hearing stories about people pissed off because you were telling me people are like throwing their stuff away during a raid so the people raiding can't get their stuff. Yeah.
They're throwing their stuff away? Really?
Yeah. So now they've got to think of a way to combat that. So when people raid, they can get their stuff.
Oh my god.
This is, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. It's just one crazy. One thing after another. It's just crazy. If I'm reading someone, they throw out their stuff, I think I'd laugh my ass off.
And just be like, all right.
Yeah.
Tucker.
I've rated a few times in Rust. It was never about getting their stuff. It was about having fun, you know?
Yeah.
But I guess that's just me. Take us out, bro. Episode 28.
We're having fun with our series. I don't give a shit.
Yeah, exactly. That's all that matters.
Exactly. All right, guys. Thank you so much for joining us. This is episode 28 for Cage. And, of course, thank you to Dread for being here.
Oh, no problem.
And to Pam.
Good night, everybody.
And, of course, to KJ48.
See you later, guys.
All right, guys. We'll catch you guys on the flip side.